Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Is the number of women at the empty tomb a contradiction?
Well, this is a great example of how somebody claims that there's a contradiction where none really exists. First of all, you have to remember that in order for a contradiction to be true, it's really on the onus of the claimant to prove that these two things can't exist at the same time and in the same way, right? Now, one gospel does talk about Mary Magdalene going to the tomb, that's John. Another one says Mary Magdalene and the other Mary. Third gospel mentions Salome in there with the two Marys. And a fourth one says that there were other women besides those three. So there could be one, two, three, five, who knows? But I don't see that as a contradiction, and I use this example. If I were to go to the theater and watch the new movie that's coming out, and then Monday morning I go to my office, I may see a coworker, an acquaintance, hey, what'd you do over the weekend? Oh, I went and saw that new movie. And he would say, great. Now, if I go sit at my desk next to my coworker and we've had some social time, our families have gotten together, he'd say, hey, you know, did you have any fun last night? Yeah, I took the wife and we got to go see the movie. Okay, great. And then my mother calls up. I said, yeah, the kids and I were with my wife as we and myself as we went and saw the movie. Now, I've not made a contradictory claim in any one of those instances. What I've done is I've used the number of people as the audience was appropriate. The coworker doesn't know my wife or my kids, so I didn't mention it. My mother, however, is going to be more interested in my children than me. So, of course, I'm going to include them. It's just an expansion of the detail. It's not a contradictory claim.